In this video, I'm going to show you why you never need to install Progrids ever again and what tool you should be using that's already built into Unity. I'll give you a quick walkthrough of the tool, compare it to Progrids, and at the end I'll give you a couple shortcuts that make it super simple for you to use. I'm Reed Stewart with Far Gaming. Let's get started. If you've tried installing Progrids anytime recently, you know it's not easy to find in the package manager. You can't just search for it or find it in the list. You have to actually go to the plus and add the package by name, which makes it feel like Unity doesn't want us to use the Progrids package anymore. And that's because they started including it right here in the scene view toolbar. You don't have to download anything extra or install any additional packages, whatever. Whenever you create a new project in Unity, this is already here. We've got three different buttons here with all sorts of different settings to play around with. You can click on these to turn them on and off. And it has almost all the same features that Progrids does. It's just in the form of these three buttons instead of having this entire panel right here inside the scene view. Doing a quick feature comparison between the two, if you want to change your grid layout, you would just go to the grid visual button, which is the first button, and you can change your grid plane to X, Y, or Z. You can also go in and change the opacity to be less, which is more transparent, or increase it to make it more solid, whichever you like more. You can also set the grid to origin, or you can set it to handle, which if you are selected on a object in your scene, I've selected my directional light, then I can move the grid so that it is centered on whatever object I've selected. And then that comes in really handy if later I need to increment so far off of whatever object it is. This is particularly useful if you're managing larger scenes. Setting it back to origin and turning it off. This was also something you could do in Progrids. You could change it from X, Y, or Z, but in Progrids, you also had this 3D grid. I don't think this feature is available anymore. If it is, drop it down in the comments and let me know. But during my time playing around with the new one, I have not been able to find this grid anymore. So that is a feature that seems to have been taken out. Next, looking at the grid snapping, I've turned off the new one and I'm using Progrids for this example. I've set the increment to 0.5, so it should be half of one of these squares. So I'll go into Pro Builder and you'll see that my point is snapping on to the halfway mark between all the squares. So I can now click and drag, create my square, and then bring it up, and everything is incrementing by 0.5. Looking at the Progrid settings for snap values, I only have one value that I'm able to set, so that applies to every single axis that I'm using. But taking a quick look at the grid snapping on the new tool, you're able to set the grid size either by a single number for all axes, or you can unlink it and you can set individual values for your different axes, whatever's going to work better for you and your situation. So to make another cube in our scene with the new tool, I'm actually going to have to completely close out of Progrids, because the snap increment up here is going to overpower whatever I have set in this one. So since this one is set to 1 and Progrids is set to 0.5, even if this one is turned on and the snapping is turned off on Progrids, this one is still going to snap with that value. So I have to go into Tools and close Progrids, and then I can come up here and click the button to turn that one back on. And now you'll see that it's snapping to the 1 increment and not 0.5 in the middle. So I can click and drag and create a cube. So now if I turn the snapping off and I was to drag this just a little bit off of the grid, you'll see I have these buttons in here for aligning the object. I can either align it on all axes at the same time. I could specifically do X, Y, or Z. So you'll see if I hit X, it just snaps it over to the nearest X grid. Or if I move it just a little bit back and I select all axes, it moves it so it's within the grid on all three axes. So lastly, we will take a look at the increment snapping button. This is where all of the shortcuts are going to come into play. So with my grid snapping turned off, I'm able to free move this stuff around. I could even go over and rotate it a little bit. But what this increment snapping will allow me to do is holding down the control key on Windows or the command key on Mac will allow me to toggle using snapping based on whatever these increments are. So moving is 0.25, so I could move this around, or if I hold down my command key, since I'm on Mac, it will let me jump 0.25 while I'm holding it down. Another thing you'll notice is since my square started off slightly off of the grid line, it is adding 0.25 to it or subtracting from it, and it's not snapping it to the grid perfectly. This also does the same thing for rotating. I can click on it and I can free rotate it, or I'll start it slightly off. And if I hold down my command key, I can jump it in increments of, I think it was 15 degrees. And again, just like with the moving, if I am starting it off slightly off center, then it is going to snap by 15 degrees in either direction, adding it or subtracting it. And you can see that by looking at my Y value for my rotation. Whenever I hold down and increment it one time, I am now at 17. So all I've done is added 15 degrees to it. Lastly, with the scale snapping, it's a little bit easier to think of this as a percentage. So one would be 100%, 0.5 would be 50%. So setting it to one, 100%, if I go in here and I try to snap this down, I'm getting rid of 100% of whatever is there. Bring it back up. If I increase it, I am adding 100% to it. Going one more time, I'm adding another 100% to it. The definition of 100% is based on what it was whenever you first started holding down the command key, because if I let go of it right now, then the scale is set to 3, and now if I hold down the command key again, 3 is now the new 100%, and I'm going to bring it down one time, and it gets rid of 100% of it. Increasing it, you'll see, takes it up to 6%. For another example, if I do change it to 0.5, that is going to be 50%. So dropping it down, the current scale is 1. So going down, I'm going to lose 50% of it. Going again, I'm going to lose the last 50% of it. Scaling it up, I'm going to add 50%, add another 50%. But if I'm starting at 2, I just released it. If I hold it down again, 50% of 2 is going to take it down to 1, and going down again is going to take it down to 0. So that's why you no longer need ProGrids. I hope you learned something and found this useful. If so, do consider liking and subscribing, as it really helps me out. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you on the next one.